Hashikomi o o su.
Taiko could mean drumming, it could also mean the drum. It's an art form that, I don't know, brings people together, and these different people come together trying to make one solid sound. You know, the modern style of taiko, what you see now, was probably started maybe around 50 years ago, the modern style, because now it's like groups that are playing. We travel around the drums. Sometimes there's like 8 people moving around the different drums. So if it's not choreographed, then we're in trouble. And that's how it makes the whole piece come together.
It's kind of a mix of music and martial arts, I guess. Because not only is it you have to look really good. So I guess it's actually dance too. Dance, music, and martial art. Because you gotta have the whole power aspect and the grace and the musicality.
It's true, there's a gradual build-up. At the beginning, it might start off soft and slow, but then at the end, it just gets crazy and loud. But that's the way we play. One of the main things that a taiko player needs to have is the right spirit and the right frame of mind. The drummer has to know that it's not just about hitting a piece of skin and making the sound. It's about playing and trying to be one with the drum. If you have the right spirit and the right attitude, I think the techniques after that will come. So in terms of like physical techniques, you need to be able to stand the right way. If you have the proper stance, that will allow you to play a little bigger. You can make your sounds a lot louder and stronger by having the right stance. The largest drum is the old taiko. It has the deepest sound and the lowest sound for sure. It's like the bass. And then the regular drums that you guys see, that's what's mainly used for the pieces. And the instrument that I was playing, we call it the cannon. And that makes the high pitched noise and that keeps the rhythm and the tempo and the timing for the pieces normally. The smaller drums that you saw that have rope around them, or sometimes they have bolts that stretch the skin and make it tight, those are called the shime. The tighter you wind it, the louder the noise, the louder the sound, the stronger the sound. The more you lessen the strain on the rope, the duller the sound.
Okay, so we use drumsticks called bocces, and that is for the medium-sized drum. We call it chudaiko. There are the big drum, odaiko, where we use a bigger, fatter, longer stick. And there's the shimedaiko, which is a lot more smaller drum that we use as a smaller stick to hit.
Since I started playing taiko, I have noticed that the art of taiko has been spreading all over the place. So when I first started, there weren't too many groups here in the Bay Area that I knew of, let alone the nation. But now, you can find groups. There's some in Houston, there's some in New York, there's some in Idaho, in Colorado. Almost every city has their own taiko group. Definitely now, taiko has become more mainstream, because when I was watching a Kanye West, and they had taiko in the background, and I said, when I started, they never had this ever.
Asher, baby. seat, screaming out loud. In the back seat, screaming out. Ashes, young, attractive, handsome bachelor, awesome.